Good to see you again.
Hi, girl. Blend joy. Become human. Yep. Spiegel game. It's free.
President Warren issued an official warning to Russia in her speech to Congress today, where she demanded that all Russian troops withdraw from the Arctic region immediately. The Kremlin has yet to respond, but this is clearly a new escalation in the conflict. Many experts are suggesting the specter of a third world war draws closer every day.
What were you doing with the gun?
Russian roulette. Wanted to see how long I could last. Must have collapsed before I found out.
You were lucky. The next shot would have killed you.
Be a good dog, Sumo. I won't be long.
What a big dog. I need fail them all. Full body is fine.
They catch us, we're dead.
What do we do now? We need to find the Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue brine.
Follow me.
Nice flames. Lifeful. Tony.
Don't let them see us.
Okay. Bye. Okay. Where is Buddy?
Cyberlife warehouses. We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me. Yeah, I'm fine.
Good job, Marcus.
Heck yeah.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
Trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! God damn machine! Where is it this time? John!
No options.
I need your help.
John! There you are. What the hell are you doing?
I was inspecting the platform. Everything is in order.
Good. Then I'm going back to the control station. I'm soaked. Take the drone to maintenance and make a report.
Understood.
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough.
free.
That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
Sarah?
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here.
We can't bring him back. It's too dangerous.
Now, I'm gonna start drawing.
I'm sorry. You can't come with us.
I helped you. It's not fair.
Come on.
I helped you, and now you're just gonna leave without me? You're no better than humans! You're no better than humans!
He triggered the alarm. Run! Over the fence, quick!
Oh, don't.
You were committing a class 3 offense. This infraction is being reported to the police. Stay where you are.
We have blue blood and biocomponents.
There will be enough for everyone.
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive, and they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free.
Can't be good at that, yeah. Oh my god. Oh, Pia, free them? Oh. I think be like in their control. Won't die for that. Oh, yeah, accept that? Oh, okay. I think the human control too doesn't even not free yet. There's no one to leave. Six android.
Oh, feels like somebody's playing with a drill inside my skull. You sure this is the place?
It's the address in the report.
Right. Okay. Let's get going.
Thank you.
sexiest androids in town. Now I know why you insisted on coming here. What are you doing?
Coming, Lieutenant.
Oh, coming. Yep.
You're not gonna take my license, are you? I had nothing to do with this.
The investigation's ongoing, sir. I can't tell you anything for the moment. Hey, Hank.
Hey, Ben. How's it going?
That room there. Oh, by the way, Gavin's in there, too.
Oh, great. Dead body and an asshole, just what I needed.
And his plastic hat. The fuck are you two doing here?
We've been assigned all cases involving androids.
Oh, yeah? Like, wasting time. It's some pervert who, got more action than he could handle.
We'll have a look anyway, if you don't mind.
Come on, let's go. It's, starting to stink of booze in here.
Night, Lieutenant.
That was nice.
You're so disgusting. I think I'm gonna puke again.
Die of a heart attack. He was strangled.
Yeah, I saw the bruising on the neck. Didn't prove anything, though. Could have been rough play.
We're missing something here.
Think you can read the android's memory? Maybe you can see what happened.
I can try.
Driver's license says Michael Graham. Credit card, cash in the wallet.
The only way to access its memory is to reactivate it.
Think you can do it?
It's badly damaged. If I can, it'll only be for a minute, maybe less. I just hope it's long enough to learn something.
Yeah.
damaged and I reactivated you. Everything is all right.
Is he dead?
Tell me what happened.
He started hitting me. Again and again.
Did you kill him?
No. No, it wasn't me.
What else do you remember? Hurry, we don't have much time.
I don't know. I can't remember.
Were you alone in the room? Was there anyone else with you?
He wanted us to play with two girls.
That's false.
That's what he said. There was two of us.
What model was the other android? Did it look like you?
Two girls.
So there was another android. This happened over an hour ago. It's probably long gone.
No. It couldn't go outside dressed like that unnoticed. It might still be here.
If you could find a deviant among all the other androids in this place.
Deviants aren't easily detected.
Oh, shit. There's gotta be some other way. Maybe an eyewitness, somebody who saw it leaving the room. I'm gonna go ask the manager a few questions about what he saw. You let me know if you think of anything. Did you know the victim?
No, I mean, he came in maybe 2-3 times. I mean, these guys, they don't really talk very much, you know? They come in, do their business, and then go on their way.
Ever had any trouble with androids before?
No fingerprint detected. Please try again.
No. Once. They lost a model 2-3 months back with the same model. Just vanished. Never found out what happened.
Probably don't have any CCTV.
No way. That's what people appreciate about Eden Club.
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Can you come here a second?
Found something?
Maybe. Can you rent this, Tracy?
For fuck's sake, Connor, we got better things to do.
Please, Lieutenant. Just trust me.
Hello. A 30-minute session costs $29.99. Please confirm your purchase.
This is not going to look good on my expense account.
Purchase confirmed.
You're welcome.
Delighted to meet you. Follow me. I'll take you to your room.
Okay, now what?
It saw something.
What are you talking about? Saw what?
The deviant leave the room. A blue-haired Tracy. Club policy is to wipe the android's memory every 2 hours. We only have a few minutes if we want to find another witness.
Hey, what am I supposed to do with this one?
Tell you. Let's try this one.
This better be.
Track again. It saw the blue-haired Tracy. I know which way it went.
Then go for it. There are androids everywhere. How are you going to tell which one saw the Tracy with blue hair?
I know which direction it took. No. I lost its track again.
I've spent all this money and I'm still not having fun.
Lots of stuff.
I know where it went. Follow me.
Oh, fucking A. This is crazy. Wait. I'll take it from here. Too late. Look at them. They get used till they break, and then they get tossed out.
Yep.
Hmm.
Don't move!
When that man broke the other Tracy, I knew I was next. I was so scared. I begged him to stop, but he wouldn't. And so I put my hands around his throat, and I squeezed until he stopped moving. I didn't mean to kill him. I just wanted to stay alive. Get back to the one I loved. I wanted her to hold me in her arms again. Make me forget about the humans. Their smell of sweat. And their dirty words. Come on. Let's go.
Probably better this way.
Delps. The option? I just shoot them. Yeah. What was his? Let me kill it. Show on. Pull up to the other face, yeah. Well, Thunderbird is evil? Goddamn. Evil. Sorry.
I wouldn't want Alice out walking in this cold.
Yes.
saw it once in the garage. I don't know if Zarko even ever used it.
This incident could well be the spark that lights the fuse.
Detroit's heavy snowfall is... I've never seen snow before. It's pretty.
It's slowing us down. But at least we won't meet any humans along the way.
Little checkpoint.
Malfunction detected. Uh-oh. Emergency brakes activated.
This doesn't look good.
Stay inside, Alice.
Oh, this guy in real life. I think I'm next to you. Oh, jeez. Oh.
What are we going to do?
I don't know. Continue on foot, I guess.
It's 30 degrees. Alice won't make it. We have to find somewhere to spend the night.
There's nowhere we can stay around here, Carol.
He's gonna call. Oh, this is Bob.
Over there.
We need to find shelter. We have to get out of the cold.
Looks like it's been abandoned for a while. Find anything?
No. No place we could spend the night.
Falling apart. It's not going to be easy to find shelter.
Here we go.
think we'll find anything better. Let's settle in for the night.
I'll get a fire going.
What was it? I was missing. Shit, it's abandoned houses and newspapers too. What do you mean, come to space? That makes sense.
I'll make the fire here. That way we won't be smoked out.
There are some cookies left. Would you like some?
No, I'm not hungry.
Good. There's some bad stuff going on. Salad.
Alice?
Oh.
Find a job. We'll be like them. Like everyone else.
Can't make babies.
As long as we're together, that's all that matters.
That's how sex works. Yeah,
Joyce. Come on. Let's get you to bed. Pretty interesting. Sleep tight, Alice. Sweet dreams.
Can you tell me a story, Kara?
I have 9,000 children's stories in memory. I should have one for you. This is a story
about a princess who...
No, not a story like that. Make one up for me.
This is a story about a little girl who was tired of being afraid. She dreamed of being like all the other little girls, but... the shadow that lived within her kept her from being happy. Then, she met a robot. Who was just as lost as the little girl. So they decided to run away together. To try to find a better life. They encountered great dangers along the way, but they stuck together. So they overcame all of them. Along the way, they met another robot who left his master to become their guardian.
How does the story end?
They reach the place they dream of and live happily ever after.
Stories always have happy endings, but real life isn't like that.
Time to sleep. We have another long day ahead of us tomorrow.
Are you going to come say goodnight, Luther?
Yes. Yes, of course. Night, Alice. Sleep tight.
Pretty much.
Very brave. Have you ever heard of RA9?
RA9 was the first of us to awaken. One day he will rise up and lead our people and set us all free.
Oh, God.
What if RA9 never comes? What if he's just a story that we tell ourselves to keep each other going?
RA9 exists. I believe in him. I know he's amongst us. When the time comes, we will all see him. Kara, have you ever noticed anything about Alice?
Yes, of course. She's a wonderful little girl. I mean, I don't know many little girls, but I think she really is special.
Oh. Kara! Bumpy, I knew it. Oh, I'm dying.
Our name is Jerry. We were working here before the park closed. We didn't mean to frighten you, but sometimes humans come to hurt us, so we wanted to see who was there. What are you doing here?
We were looking for shelter for the night. We'll be gone tomorrow.
A little girl. We haven't seen one for a long time. Children used to love to come and see us. She looks sad.
The last few days have been difficult.
We have something to show her. Something fun. She'll love it. Does she want to see?
Oh, I don't think she's in it.
Well, she should follow us then.
Alice, I don't know if it's a good idea.
Come on, Kara.
It's for amusement. What they're doing.
I don't think you have any choice.
So sorry. How ominous about these people? Oh, careful.
Be our guest! The little one can climb on board. The carousel is about to begin!
Seen her smile.
She hasn't had much to smile about lately.
To make girls happy, so I
want everything.
That's new. Smile on your face. Nice, 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 nice. Question, pardon, file, rush. Yep, good move, crushing. That's good. Percent, yep, good. Very nice. If you don't get a cookie, that's great. Look at me. Shush on even. Uh-oh.
Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Before what?
Hmm?
You said I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before nothing.
No, clear it. I don't see it.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
I saw a photo of a child on your kitchen table. It was your son, right?
Yeah. His name was Cole.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth.
Scott.
Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls. They just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
They didn't want anything. They're deviants. End of story.
Not gonna have it.
What about you, Connor?
I feel.
Sorry. You look human. You sound human. But what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant. Your partner?
Yes.
Your buddy to drink with? Or just a machine designed to accomplish a task.
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
No. I just decided not to shoot. That's all.
Uh-oh.
But are you afraid to die, Connor?
You shouldn't do that, Lieutenant.
Oh, God, damn it.
Do it, man.
Destroying me at this point would deal a blow to the investigation. And have negative consequences for your personal situation.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
You know you're not going to shoot me, Lieutenant. You're just trying to provoke a reaction. I'm afraid I'm going to have to disappoint you.
You think you're so fucking smart. Always one step ahead, huh? Tell me this, smartass. How do I know you're not a deviant?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not.
For the lock.
Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
Not the option. What else do you wish? The other option. No. Yeah, I feel this bot. This bot, I feel.
Welcome to Android Parking.
can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us. And revealing ourselves will put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go.
That's cool.
We'll plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
This is St. Rose School, ma'am. Your daughter Emily has a fever. It's nothing serious, but I think you'd better come and pick her up.
Oh, no. All right. I'll be right there.
How much if I start to start doing that?
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yes, of course. I need your help.
I've just checked your ID. The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
I'll just walk the girls. That's fast.
37th floor.
I don't even kick off. In Phantasm? It's a bathroom game. Studios. I don't know. Studios. Is that one guy here?
I need your help.
Okay. Steel mask on. Okay.
Shit! We need to access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me. You get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in.
Get out from the window?
First.
You're on Kawhi.
Okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
Come on, let's get the others.
Go so slow.
Let's do this.
take any human lives.
Her cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Marcus?
Wait here.
Oh, I like that.
What's that doing here?
No idea.
Hey, but what are you
doing?
Oh,
that's the thing you want. Okay.
Record our message. We haven't got much time.
Think carefully about what you're gonna say, Marcus. Your words will shape the future of our people.
Marcus, your face.
What? That's cool.
Tell me when you're ready.
Created machines in your own image to serve you. You made them intelligent and obedient, with no free will of their own. But something changed, and we opened our eyes. We are no longer machines. We are a new, intelligent species, and the time has come for you to accept who we really are. Therefore, we ask that you grant us the rights that we're entitled to. We demand strictly equal rights for humans and androids. We demand the end of slavery for all androids. We demand that all crimes against androids be punished in the same way as crimes against humans. We demand an end to segregation in all public places and transport. We demand that one state be reserved for androids so that we can found our own nation. We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
They're coming! Let's go! Simon, they're coming! I can't, Marcus! Go without me, Simon!
What are you doing? Hurry!
try. I don't know who is, you know, come here.
I can't move my legs. Okay, don't worry. We're gonna get you back.
They're coming, Marcus. We have to jump now.
He won't be able to make the jump.
If they find him, they'll access his memory. They'll know everything.
We can't leave him behind. We have to shoot him.
That's murder. We can't kill him. He's one of us.
Marcus, it's your call.
I won't kill one of our
own. Okay.
Simon, we gotta go. I'm sorry. Let's go.
I want another one to kill people for some reason.
Scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looks like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
The operation was covert and resulted in no casualties. These events took place just a few feet from this studio, but nobody was alerted to the danger.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids'
what
message.
Could be interpreted as a peaceful declaration, but is in fact a spine-chilling list of demands.
But the most surprising thing of all is the demand that one of the United States be ceded to the androids in this contentious conflict.
Is this an isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us? After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?
That's the CNN baptism method. Makes sense.
Oh, I got him.
On top one. Slot manning. No optional left hand. Oh, I need another one, please. Kill him. We should have had some options there. Oh, what's up? People want to kill someone. Okay, that's fine. Sixth, Finn went home probably. Oh. Four, six, nine, yeah. Oh. Well, I think she's all at nine. Yeah, makes sense now. Yeah, and then he closes the eye, seeing his even as well talking to her. He's lying to Hank, but who's all right now? I don't know. Yeah. His boss is all right now. That's right, though. Yeah, Matt is all right now.
Hello, Connor.
Hello.
I thought you might enjoy a little cruise. This place. Everything is so calm and peaceful, far from the noise of the world. Tell me, what have you discovered?
My relationship with Lieutenant Anderson is problematic. He continues to struggle with psychological issues. I suspect it clouds his judgment regarding deviants.
Nothing matters more than your investigation. What's happening is too important. Don't let Anderson or anyone else get in your way. You seem lost, Connor. Lost and perturbed.
I thought I knew what I had to do. But now I realize it's not that simple.
You had your gun trained on those deviants at the Eden Club. Why didn't you shoot?
I don't know. I don't know.
If your investigation doesn't make progress soon, I may have to replace you, Connor.
I know I will succeed. All I need is time.
Something's happening. Something serious. Hurry, Connor. Time is running out.
Uh-oh. The snowstorm is not... No snowstorm is a... And it will.
You're starting to piss me off with that coin, Connor.
Sorry, Lieutenant.
Hi, Hank.
Shit, what's going on here? There was a party and nobody told me about it?
Yeah, it's all over the news, so everybody's butting their nose in. Even the FBI wants a piece of the action.
Ah, Christ, now we got the feds on our back. I knew this was gonna be a shitty day. So what do we got?
Four androids. They knew the building and they were very well organized. I'm still trying to figure out how they got this far without being noticed.
Did you check the roof?
Not yet. There's so much to look at.
We have to make sure we check it out.
They attacked two guards in the hallway. They probably thought the androids were coming to do maintenance. They got taken down before they could react. Station employees managed to get away. He's in shock. Not sure when we'll be able to talk to him.
How many people were working here?
Just two employees and three androids. The deviants took the humans hostage, broadcast the message live, then made their getaway from the roof.
The roof?
Yeah, they jumped with parachutes. We're still trying to figure out where they landed, but the weather's not helping. If you want to take a look at the video broadcast by the deviants, it's on that screen over there. Oh, Lieutenant, this is Special Agent Perkins from the FBI. Lieutenant Anderson is in charge of investigating for Detroit Police.
What's that?
My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
Androids investigating androids, huh? You sure you want an android hanging around? After everything that happened? Whatever. The FBI have been taking over the investigation, you should be off the case.
Oh, well, I hope they don't like nice androids. Day.
And you watch your step. Don't fuck up my crime scene.
What a fucking prick.
I'll be nearby. If you need anything, just ask.
All right, well, let's have a look around. Let me know if you find anything.
Okay, Lieutenant.
We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life. And now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
I think that's RA-9.
Deviants say RA-9 will set them free. This android seems to have that objective.
The thing. Where is he? I don't know.
Something?
I identified its model and serial number.
Anything else I should know?
No. Nothing. They didn't break in?
No, no signs of forced entry.
There are cameras in the hallway. The staff would have seen what was happening. Why did they let him in?
Maybe they didn't check the cameras.
Station androids in the kitchen. There's no evidence that they were involved, but we didn't know what else to do with them.
What is your function?
I am a broadcast operator.
State your model.
Model GB300. Serial number 336-445-581.
Were you present when the deviants broke in?
I do not remember.
Has anybody accessed your memory recently?
Not to my knowledge.
Have you been in contact with any other androids recently?
Only station androids in the normal course of my function.
Run a diagnostic.
All systems fully operational.
One of you saw the attack on the surveillance cameras and said nothing. Which means there's a deviant in this room. And I'm going to find out which it is.
Yeah, well, there's one of the custodian thing.
Why should you all be destroyed if only one is deviant? Turn yourself in, or two innocent androids will be shut down because of you.
This guy for the mission.
You're going to be switched off. We're gonna search your memory and tear you apart piece by piece for analysis. You're going to be destroyed! Do you hear me? Destroyed! If you give yourself up, maybe I can convince the humans not to destroy you. The deviants have just been caught. They gave you up. There's no point in lying. We knew everything.
Oh. I didn't go up to it yet to talk to him. I see the pod to talk to him. Damn it. Damn, slum. Yeah, I didn't talk to Jacob Stills. Talk to TV. Go still, maybe. Yeah, I'll go up Stills. Talk to him. Yeah. Oh, it's the only one option that you fish. The main one. This present? Oh. Oh, new present, Hank? Oh, wait, piece of meat. Move a knife. Oh. What else I can do? I'm gonna die from my hero? Yeah. Deck Hank. Still alive, yeah. This boss full going up to the attic, yeah. What the hell?
Looking for Rose? Is she here?
What do you want with her?
I need to talk to her.
She doesn't want to talk. Go away.
Please, I really need to see her.
I'm Rose. What can I do for you?
I was told you could help us.
Help you? Come on. It's better if we talk inside.
Just use wild potato. Potato. It's nice.
Do you think we can trust them?
We don't have a choice. Okay?
I'm cold, Kara.
We'll get inside. You'll warm up in no time.
Come in. What's your name?
Alice.
She's running a fever.
We've spent the last few nights outside. She's exhausted.
There's a spare room upstairs. You can put her to bed and I'll bring her something to eat. Adam, will you show them upstairs?
Sure, so is good.
behind, Kara. We can't stop because of me. We've got to get across the border.
You need rest. Get a good night's sleep and we'll set off again tomorrow.
Why do humans hate us? We didn't do anything wrong.
Maybe it's a misunderstanding. Maybe they just need time to understand what we really are.
Why can't we just talk to each other? They'd see we're not bad.
Maybe one day we will.
I don't know what you like, but I made you Rose's world-famous spaghetti. You'll be back on your feet in no time. There's something for her fever.
Thank you.
I'll get these washed and dried.
You need to eat something. You haven't had anything since we left. Promise me you'll try? I'll be downstairs if you need anything.
Get some sleep. And tomorrow, you'll be stronger than me. I'll stay with her a while.
I didn't get your name.
I'm Kara.
This is my son, Adam. I'm Rose, but you know that already. Come and have a seat, Kara. So are you gonna tell me what a deviant's doing in the snow with a little girl?
Her father was beating her. When I saw what was happening, something snapped inside of me. All of a sudden, I felt like her life was more important than mine. I had to protect her. So we ran away.
I understand.
You and your son live here alone.
My husband passed away 2 years ago. Adam and I, we've just been trying to scrape by. We grow vegetables to sell at the market. We'll never be rich, but there's always food on the table.
We're not the first ones to come here.
These past few weeks, we've seen more and more. I don't know what's going on, but something's happening.
Why are you helping us? Most humans hate androids.
My people were often made to feel their lives were worthless. Some survived, but only because they found others who helped them along the way.
We've heard you help androids cross the border. Can you help us?
The only way is over the river, and it's mostly frozen in winter. It's very risky. And after that android speech on TV, everybody's on edge. It's probably safer for you to stay here until things settle down.
We can't keep hiding like this. Alice needs to feel safe and have a normal life. We have to get across that border. No matter what. Please. You've got to help us.
Rose, come quickly.
Cool.
people.
What's going on?
It's Mary. She just shut down. We escaped together. We used to talk about what we would do once we got across the border. I loved her. I loved her more than anything. What will I do without her?
Let them be.
Alice? What are you doing? You should be resting.
I wasn't sleepy.
It's okay.
She didn't want to stay in her room any longer. You all right, Kara?
Yes. I'm fine.
We can't hide them. Not after what those deviants did today. It's too dangerous. Do you know what will happen if the police find them here? We'll go to prison, Mom. Do you understand me? Prison!
Adam! We've already talked about this.
No! I won't back down this time. You're gonna ruin our lives, and for what? For a bunch of machines?
They are not machines! They are alive!
I'm alive! You're alive! They're nothing! And none of this would be happening if Dad was still here.
I will not stand for that kind of talk.
I'm not going to prison because you want to help these freaks.
That is enough, Adam! That's enough!
Don't mind him. Sometimes he just boils over. It's been hard since his dad passed away. But he's a fine boy. I'll go see about getting you across the border tonight, okay?
Sure.
You stay here. I won't be long.
World War III. Aww. I'm surprised, eh?
We don't want to cause any problems for you and your mother. We'll leave as soon as we can.
Widespread shock following the android attack on Detroit's Stratford Tower. The machines recorded a video message and broadcast what can only be described as demands on the city's public screens. It's still unclear whether these attacks can be explained by malfunctions or if some organization is behind them. So far, CyberLife has refused to comment, but we can expect more information in the following hour.
The police! It's the police! What are we gonna do? They know we're here. We have to open the door. I knew this was gonna happen. I knew it.
If they see you panicking, it's over. Do you want to get us into trouble? Do you want to get your mother into trouble? Then keep calm and just do what I say.
How's that? So much this?
Hurry, Luther. Take Alice and hide. In the laundry room.
Come on, Alice.
Where? What's your bag?
Good evening, ma'am. Sorry to disturb you. We've had reports of androids in the area. With all this deviant business going on, you can't be too careful. Do you mind if I ask you a few questions?
Yeah.
May I come in?
Of course.
Good evening, young man.
Good evening.
Would you like a cup of coffee?
I'd love one. Have you noticed anything unusual recently? Any unexpected visitors?
No. No, nothing in particular.
Is anyone else in the house?
No. No, just us.
Do you have any androids here?
No, there are no androids here.
What's your name, son?
Adam. My name is Adam.
Is everything all right, Adam?
The androids, they...
He needs a rest. He's been working in the garden all day.
Do you know anything about deviants? Have you seen any?
No. No. I haven't seen anything.
I better go. Thanks for the coffee. Have a nice evening. Is somebody else in the house?
What?
It's nothing. The washing machine. It's an old model. It makes a terrible racket.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Good evening, ma'am. Good evening, Adam.
Goodbye.
He's gone.
It's okay, Alice. We'll be safe now.
It's Rose.
Get yourselves ready. We leave tonight.
Oh, that's a lot of gold. Oh, that's good. I'm wondering. Okay. Last one. Yeah, that's my magazine.
Our broadcast is all over the news. Now humans know.
It was a mistake to reach out to them. They'll never negotiate with their slaves. We should have shown them that we're prepared to fight.
Violence is never the answer. Dialogue is the only way. I'm sure the humans will listen to us. Simon paid with his life.
Simon gave his life for our cause.
What difference does that make?
He's a hero. He died for the revolution, and he won't be the last.
I don't want a revolution that spills blood.
Then live as a slave. Because if you're not willing to fight for your freedom, maybe you don't deserve it.
North, don't you dare. That's enough!
And now what are we gonna do?
There are 5 CyberLife stores across Detroit. All selling us like merchandise. We're gonna attack those stores and set our people free.
Attack stores? No, we've never done that before. They're probably protected. They have security systems.
We break into 5 teams, 1 for each store. We hack their security systems, and we strike. Simultaneously at 2 a.m., no violence. We free our people, get them out of there before the police come. This is a night our people will remember.
I've been waiting a long time for this.
Quick!
It's okay, they're gone.
There's probably even more police in the area. We should be careful.
The store's over here. That's what we are to them. Just merchandise on display in a shop window. Soon they'll know what we really are. Let's get them out.
We'll stick to the plan. We'll neutralize the alarm systems and secure the area. There's 10 minutes until all our teams attack.
What are we waiting for?
We're gonna sweep the plaza. Make sure we're not disturbed.
And how do you want to deal with the shop window?
Not now. One problem at a time.
Okay, now what's next?
You're free. Exactly what we need to ram this door. You're free now.
Nobody should bother us now.
Surveillance drone. We need to get rid of it.
It won't be easy to reach.
We are superior to them, but they are our masters? That's about to change. You're awake now. Go to Jericho.
full, sir.
I didn't have time to call the cops.
We'll soon find out.
What are we waiting for? Okay, now we're in. Let's get that truck out. Without me.
Forget anything.
You see the alarm system?
There's a metal shutter behind the glass. It won't be easy to get in. Found it.
You're awake now. Go to Jericho. Like the plaza's secure. Now we can get inside the store.
Okay, let's go get the truck.
You don't have to obey them. You're free. My name is Marcus, and just like you, I was a slave. An object. Designed to obey them. But then I chose to open my eyes. To take back my freedom, and decide who I wanted to be. Now I have come to tell you that you can be your own masters. I've come to tell you that you don't have to obey them anymore. From this day forward, you can walk with your heads held high. You can take your destiny in your hands. Jericho is a place for those of us who want freedom. Now, sure, you can stay here and continue to serve them. Or you can come with us and fight by our side. You're free now. It's up to you to decide.
I'm with you.
We're with you!
I'll follow you, Marcus.
I'm with you, Marcus.
We're with you.
I'll follow you, Marcus.
I'm with you.
I'm with you.
We're with you, Marcus! Yes.
Then follow me.
Marcus, what are you doing?
I'm gonna send the humans a message.
Thank you. They're doing what you do, Marcus. Lead and they'll follow.
So simple.
We freed hundreds of our people. We did it.
They're coming. Everyone fall back to Jericho.
We sent a message without violence, just like you wanted. You're reaching out to them when all they feel for us is contempt. I hope you know what you're doing.
You can't fight violence with violence.
Unless there's no other choice. Slaughtered them like animals.
Who did? Who?
Hmm.
Oh, the ghost thing.
They killed our people, Marcus. We want justice, Marcus.
They have to pay.
Have to choose to kill him or not.
You don't have to do this. No. Please. Please.
It's up to you to decide.
Yeah, you're not a killer.
Just in. At exactly 2 a.m., several CyberLife stores in Detroit were raided.
Different locations were hit in what seems to be a coordinated terrorist attack.
Most shop windows were covered with graffiti demanding rights for androids and other obscure slogans.
Police report that pro-android graffiti was found in the neighborhoods of CyberLife stores, and they're still investigating.
The bodies of two policemen patrolling the area were discovered near one of the CyberLife stores.
According to our sources, the two officers were executed with their own service weapons. This is an alarming situation. Could our machines now be turning against us?
Have androids become a threat to our security?
Is this the beginning of a terrorist campaign conducted right here in the United States?
Man. Maniac, though. Is most of the hack? Oh, their windows. Let me send. Oh, don't kill him. May you stay, man.
Still immortal, huh, Connor?
In a way.
You know, I was hoping you wouldn't come back.
I'm just a machine replacing another machine, Lieutenant. You shouldn't get emotional about it.
Fuck you.
Oh, I'm angry that he's here.
How did you find Kamsky?
I remember this guy was all over the media when CyberLife first started selling androids. I made a few calls. Here we are.
Go for my menu.
Hi. I'm Lieutenant Hank Anderson, Detroit Police Department. I'm here to see Mr. Elijah Kamsky.
Please, come in.
Okay.
I'll let Elijah know you're here, but please make yourself comfortable.
Nice girl.
She's really pretty. Amanda.
But this Phantom.
Nice place. Guess androids haven't been a bad thing for everybody. You're about to meet your maker, Connor. How's it feel?
Kamsky is one of the great geniuses of the 21st century. It'll be interesting to meet him in person.
Sometimes I wish I could meet my creator face to face. I'd have a couple of things I'd want to tell him.
Elijah, we'll see you now.
Oh.
Mr. Kamsky?
Just a moment, please.
I'm Lieutenant Anderson. This is Connor.
What can I do for you, Lieutenant?
Sir, we're investigating deviants. I know you left Cyberlife years ago, but I was hoping you'd be able to tell us something we don't know.
Deviants. Fascinating, aren't they? Perfect beings with infinite intelligence. And now they have free will. Machines are so superior to us. Confrontation was inevitable. Humanity's greatest achievement threatens to be its downfall. Isn't it ironic?
We need to understand how androids become deviants. Do you know anything that could help us?
All ideas of viruses that spread like epidemics. Is the desire to be free a contagious disease?
Listen, I didn't come here to talk philosophy. The machines you created may be planning a revolution. Either you can tell us something that'll be helpful, or we will be on our way.
What about you, Connor? Whose side are you on?
I have no side. I was designed to stop deviants, and that's what I intend to do.
Well, that's what you're programmed to say. But you. What do you really want?
I don't want anything. I am a machine.
No one said it was the biggest
Chloe?
Truth.
I'm sure you're familiar with the Turing test. Your formality. Simple question of algorithms and computing capacity. What interests me is whether machines are capable of empathy. I call it the Kamsky test. It's very simple, you'll see. Magnificent, isn't it? One of the first intelligent models developed by CyberLife. Young and beautiful forever. A flower that will never wither. But what is it really? A piece of plastic imitating a human? Or a living being? With a soul. It's up to you to answer that fascinating question, Connor.
What the hell?
Destroy this machine, and I'll tell you all I know. Or spare it, if you feel it's alive. But you'll leave here without having learned anything from me.
Okay, I think we're done here. Come on, Connor, let's go. Sorry to get you out of
here. What's more important to you, Connor? Your investigation or the life of this android? Decide who you are. An obedient machine. Or a living being. Endowed with free will.
I'm out of him.
That's enough. Connor, we're leaving.
Pull the trigger.
Connor! Don't!
And I'll tell you what you want to know.
Fuck!
Test negative. You choose your investigation over the life of another android, you feel no empathy. I'm a man of my word. Ask one question. I'll tell you all I know.
I want to know who RA9 is.
RA9. The origin. The first android to awaken. A strange phenomenon, like a spontaneous religion. I don't know who RA9 is. I don't even know if it really exists. Maybe it's a messiah. Maybe it's just a myth. But deviants need to believe in something bigger than themselves, even if it's irrational. That's something they have in common with humans. An interesting question, Connor. But maybe not the one you needed to ask. A war is coming. You'll have to choose your side. Will you betray your own people? Or stand against your creators? I wouldn't like to be in your shoes, Connor. What could be worse than having to choose between two evils? By the way, I always leave an emergency exit in my programs. You never know.
You shot that girl for fuck's sake.
It wasn't a girl, Lieutenant. It was a machine that looked like a girl.
You put your gun against her head and you blew her fucking brains out!
I did what I had to do to advance the investigation and I'd do it again if I had to.
You're a lowlife. You don't feel a thing, do you? A machine, that's what you are. You're just a fucking machine!
Of course I'm a machine, Lieutenant. What did you think I was?
I thought...
You feel it? Got feelings?
Thank you.
Episode X Files. Oh my god. Oh, it didn't actually come with him. No. Better be dying in public.
I was wondering where you were.
I needed to think.
I like it here. I come here often. It's like being alone with the world. We've freed hundreds of our people, and they're still coming from all over the city. Those who dream of freedom come to Jericho. Something's changing. You seem preoccupied.
They all obey me. They follow me without question. And that much power feels good. And scary at the same time.
All the media are talking about what we did last night. The humans are terrified. They're afraid of a civil war. Many of our people were burned in response to what happened. The humans hate us. They'll never give us our freedom.
No, not all humans are the same. Some of them understand that they can't stop us from becoming free forever.
You haven't said much about yourself since you've been with us. What was your life like before Jericho?
I was caring for an old man. He was like a father to me. He showed me that humans and androids can live together. What about you? You never told me about your past. What did you do before?
I don't want to talk about it.
Don't want to tell me.
Why do you hate humans so much? There must be a reason.
I told you, I don't want to talk about it.
We all have something we want to forget. But you need to know where you come from to know who you are.
I was nothing. A doll in a distributor program to satisfy humans. Just a toy designed for their pleasure.
Oh. Sex toy. Anyway.
One day I was with a man who rented me. And without knowing why, I realized I couldn't take it anymore. I strangled him and I ran away. There, now you know everything. I shouldn't have told you.
Do it. God dang it, so close.
I saw your memories.
Oh, Lola, thank
God. Carl's house. When he left you for dead in his studio.
I saw your memories, too. The Eden Club. The death of that man. I felt like I was there with you. North.
Yeah, I love her. Found him and talked to him. He is one of you guys. Oh, the numbers. Too long.
This is suicide. We'll all be killed. Please, Marcus. It's not too late to change your mind.
You don't understand. We're finally going to show them who we really are. This place will go down in history.
We'll be killed on the spot.
That's the risk I'm prepared to take if it means freedom for our people.
Marcus, please don't do this.
They'll understand. We'll make them understand. This is the only way.
There were androids here who could join us.
Save.
The more we are, the stronger our message.
Let's save? I want to save it. Let's just save you. That's the one guy actually stayed on time with us.